Good morning, students. In the last four videos, we have seen the four parts of the lesson and the explanation. Today, we are going to read the summary of the lesson, the question answer, and working with language in your textbook. Let us first read the summary of the lesson.
The lesson Bibin Chowdhury's Lapse of Memory is a story by Satyajit Rai. Bibin is very cleverly tricked by Chunilal for not receiving much needed help from him. Chunilal had requested Bibin Chowdhury to get him a job, but Bibin did not help him much. On being hurt by his friend's indifference, Chunilal made a plan to teach Bibin a lesson by creating such a situation for Bibin that he began feeling he was suffering from amnesia. Amnesia means loss of memory. Now we will do working with the text. It has four questions. I'll discuss each questions with you, and the key points of the answers will be flashed on the screen in front of you. Let's start with the first question. The author described Bipin Babu as a serious and hardworking man. What evidence can you find in the story to support this? Answer 1. Bipin Babu worked daily in his office. It was a big firm. He was doing a responsible job. He had been with the firm for last 25 years. He was a tireless and conscientious worker. Question number 2. Why did Bibin Babu change his mind about meeting Chunilal? What was the result of this meeting? Answer 2. Bibin Babu changed his mind about meeting Chunilal because he thought that Chunilal might remember anything about his. When Chunilal confirmed about the Ranji trip, then Bibin Babu decided to see a specialist doctor. Question number 3. Bibin Babu lost consciousness at Hoodoo Falls. What do you think was the reason for this? Answer 3. Bibin Babu was too stressed mentally because he was all the time thinking about whether the Ranji trip was real or not. Due to this stress, he felt unconscious at Hoodoo Falls. Now question number 4. How do you think Bibin Babu reacted when he found out that Chunilal had tricked him? Answer 4. Bibin Babu must have felt sorry for the unfeeling behavior, and he must have realized that it wasn't the Ranchi trip but the meaning of friendship that he had forgotten. Now working with language, look at these two sentences. He had to buy at least 5 books to last him through the week. Second sentence, Bibin had to ask Chunni to leave. Had to is used to show that it was very important or necessary for Bibin Babu to do something. He had no choice. We can also use have to or has to in the same. First one, I have to cut my hair every month. Second, we had to go for swimming lessons last year. Now, here we are putting had to because the phrase last year tells us that it is in the past. Third one, she has to tell the principal the truth. They have to take the baby to the doctor. We have to complain to the police about the noise. Fifth one, Romit had to finish his homework before he could come out to play. Since could is in the past, so we use had to. Now seventh one, I had to repair my cycle yesterday. Now the word yesterday tells us that it is in the past tense, so had to. Second question, here are a few idioms that you will find in the story. Look for them in the dictionary in the following way. Here there are five idioms here. First you have to arrange in the order. For example, if you have to search for the meaning of first one, at or from close quarters, then have, then which is the adjective here? Close. And in the dictionary we should have searched the word closed. You have to ignore the articles and the prepositions in the idiom which come in the beginning. So first you have to pick up the noun or verb or adverb or adjective and then look for their meaning. And then take that for the meaning. In the first one it is closed, and in the second break into a smile. Here break is a verb. Third, carry on. Here you should see the meaning carry. Carry here is a verb. And fourth one, have a clean record. You might you may find related meanings under both these words. You can check either clean or record. Fifth one, beat about the bush. Here beat is the verb. Now question number 3, study the sentences in the column below. There are two columns, A and B. There is a difference in the tenses used here in column A and in column B. In column A, the tenses used here are simple past, and in column B, it is present perfect. So here, put this number like this way. There are some mistake in the order of the sentence and the question. That's why you have to arrange the sentences like this way. 3, 1, 2, 4. Now we will read the first question. Compare the sentences in two columns, especially in the verb forms. Answer the following questions about each pair of sentences. First, which column tells us that Bibin Babu is still working at the same place? First one, okay, Bibin Babu worked here for a week last year. And in the second column, Bibin Babu has worked here since 2003. There is some correction is there in the second sentence. You just cut has worked and you add there has been working here since 2003. So the answer is column B, Bibin Babu has been working here since 2003. Now second sentences, Chunilal write to a publisher last week. Chunilal has written to a publisher. So the question is, which column suggests that Chunilal is now waiting for a reply from the publisher? Answer column B. Now third sentence, I saw this movie yesterday. I have seen this movie already. Which column suggests that the person still remembers the movie he saw? Answer is column B. Now fourth question. Fourth sentence, I visited Ranchi once long ago. I have visited Ranchi once before. Question, which column suggests that the experience of visiting Ranchi is still fresh in the answer is column B. Question 4. Given below are jumbled sentences. Working in groups, rearrange the words in each sentences to form correct sentences. You will find that each sentences contains an idiomatic expression that you have come across in the lesson. Underline the idiom and write down its meaning. Then use your dictionary to check the meaning. Okay, example is given. Jumbled sentence, vanish the car seem to into thin half air. Answer, the car seem to have vanished into thin air. Here, the idiom is vanished into thin air. The meaning is disappeared or vanished in a mysterious way. Now question number 1. There are 5 parts. We have to put together all these parts in proper sentences and find the idiom. Second answer, stop beating about the bush and tell me what you want. Here idiom is beating about the bush, meaning avoiding the main topic. Second answer, if you don't pay attention to the announcement, you might board the wrong train. Here idiom is to pay attention, the meaning to listen carefully. Answer, the villagers tried to pin the crime of the young woman. The idiom is to pin the crime and the meaning to be. Now the rest two are homework for you. We will discuss the answers in the Zoom class. That's all in the video. I hope you have understood the lesson. Take good care of yourself. I'll come up with a new topic in the next video. Till then. Bye.